स्टार्ट। श्री सिद्धार्थ वर्मा, लर्नेड काउंसिल फॉर द अपीलेंट, हैज सबमिटेड दैट द फाइंडिंग रिकॉर्डेड बाय द डिस्ट्रिक्ट जज इन द इम्प्यूंड ऑर्डर ऑन द इशू ऑफ नॉन सर्विस ऑफ नोटिसेस अपॉन द एलॉटी प्रायर टू कैंसिलेशन ऑफ हिज लीज डीड इज इलीगल एंड इज नॉट बेस्ड ऑन एनी मटेरियल ऑन रिकॉर्ड स्टॉप। He further submits that the finding recorded that the allottee did not get any opportunity of hearing before cancellation of the lease deed is illegal. Stop. He also states that the application invoking the arbitration clause made by Srimati Leela Mathur on 4/3/1998 was beyond time and barred by limitation and the finding contrary thereto recorded in the impugned order is erroneous. Stop. Learned counsel has also challenged the locus standi of Srimati Leela Mathur to maintain the proceedings under section 34 of the Arbitration and Cancellation Act on the basis that although she was wife of the allottee, she did not possess a registered power of the attorney to act on his behalf. Stop. A further submission is made that no grounds were made out for setting aside the award as enumerated in section 34 of the act and therefore the impugned order has been passed illegally. Stop. Para. Srimati Leela Mathur, wife of the allottee Sri D.S. Mathur, appearing in person, has argued that her husband is living abroad and has authorized her by issuing a power of attorney in her favor and even otherwise being wife of the allottee, she is entitled to maintain these proceedings. Stop. She has admitted the execution of the lease deed in favor of her husband of the plot in question. Stop. Her main submission is that the allottee was never served with any notice prior to cancellation of the lease deed and re-entry by the corporation. Stop. It is submitted that on 16/11/1995 the corporation wrote a letter to the allottee that since the terms and conditions have been violated and notices dated 24/4/1984 and 2/5/1984 have already been issued and some but even then default has been made by the allottee, hence in view of the violation of the lease conditions by notice dated 17/2/1986, the allotment has been cancelled and corporation has re-entered on 24/2/1986. Stop. It was also informed that the land has been allotted to another person. Stop. She submits that the allottee protested against the said letter dated 16/11/1995 and corporation correspondence took place between the parties on several dates. Stop. Para. While considering the application under section 34 of the act for setting aside the award dated 31/12/1999, the district judge Ghaziabad considered the question of limitation and recorded that notice dated 24/4/1984 was sent to the allottee at the factory address and his London address, but the allottee has denied receipt of the notice and stated that earlier correspondence was made by the corporation to the allottee on his Delhi address, but deliberately the notice for cancellation of lease deed was not sent to the Delhi address. Stop. The district judge found that UP State Industrial Development Corporation Limited had sent the receipt of payment of ₹2000 to the allottee at his Delhi address, which was the address of the father-in-law of the allottee. Stopera. It has been recorded that the notice sent to the factory address and London address were returned unserved and the corporation again sent a notice at the same address. Stop. The district judge found that the notice dated 24/4/1984 was not served on the allottee prior to cancellation of the lease deed and hence the allottee was not given any opportunity of hearing prior to cancellation of his lease deed nor the intimation of cancellation ऑफ द लीज डीड बाई लेटर डेटेड 17 to 1986 वॉज एवर सर्व्ड ऑन द एलॉटी।